two from China. No surprise there. Here's how the mixed doubles draw has panned out. We saw both semi-finals yesterday if you were with us. Both went to three games. So this could be close. On their way out, as you can see. Always, sir. A great atmosphere in the mixed doubles.
Right. Sir. We receive. Okay.
So let's give you some details about CHOI. We've already seen him in the men's doubles. He was actually a successful singles player when he was a youth. Won this title in 2014. She won three other titles with different partners. SHIN, who was in the top 20 last year, that highest ranking. Obviously, we've seen her as well this afternoon already, the women's doubles final. Got a bronze in Rio at the Olympics in women's doubles. And also a world championship bronze in 2014 too. There's their path to the final. Just had the three-game match once, which was in the semi yesterday against Jordan and Octaviente. And their opponents, Ko Sung Hyun, ranked number one back in 2013. He was also ranked one in the men's doubles too. He's won seven mixed doubles titles with Kim Ha Na. There's his current partner, Yum Hai Won, 27 years of age. Actually won her only mixed doubles title with Ko way back in 2011, Chinese Taipei Open. We had to play a qualifying round.
And they've battled
through to make this final. Ruh Hyung Ho, the umpire, and Kang Sun Young, the service judge for this match.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Ko Sung Hyun and on her right, Korea.
and on my left, Chester Hugh and Simpson Chan, Korea. Simpson Chan serve to Ho Sang-hyun. Lovable play.
Here we go then for our last final of the day. Straight away, Ko going across, showing he means business. Nicely picked off at the net. 31 now he is, Ko. Still moves pretty well around the court. Subtle touch that was. Well, from the sublime to the ridiculous, I guess. Entertaining rally, but Ko's presence in this final already making itself felt. It's off to a bit of a flyer here, Ko and Yeom. Fight backs on, apparently. Great reactions from Shin. Thank you. That's a really impressive fight back from 7-1 down. Does launch into those, doesn't he? At the moment, his power and Eom's subtlety winning the day against Choi and Shin, but that was right on the line, right on the line. Coming to the party. What a shot. Well, when he hits him, they stay here. Wasn't high enough, the serve, and he got the treatment. A small lead at the mid-game interval, 11-9 in favour of Konya. Shin way less experienced than their opponents, both 23, Coast 31, Young 27. He hangs. Looks like a basketball player. Better go for a slam dunk. And then dispatches it. Say he's disappointed, but that's an understatement after such a phenomenal shot the point before. Just a power merchant. Hey. That was hit very firmly by Choi. Seen the power, now you've seen the subtlety too. This time he picks. Picks it off at the net on the backhand. Co. Miscues. One from Choi, one from Shin. The result of which is Ko and EOM closing in on the opening game. Well, that was half a chance. Has opened up the court well, and he's put another one away to set up the first of eight game points. Well, that'll do. 21-12 in just 14 minutes. And Ko Sung Hyun has rather dominated that opening game.
떨어뜨리는데 다시 돌잖아. 그러면 아예 그냥 반대로 가십니다. 다시 놀라고 가고, 백도도 마찬가지고. 그것만 하면은, 어차피 다 비슷한데 탄도 포인트 있어요. 그것만, 그것만 생각하면.
A bit too eager, maybe there. Yeah. Lightning hand speed. A bit too much for him that time. A spirited response this, having lost the opening game from SHIN and CHOI. Can't believe you missed that. I was trying to hit that too hard. You see what your opponent, Ko, is doing at the other end of the court. Might be the first one of those he's missed. Certainly hasn't been many. Thought it was long, it's been challenged. Yeah, well long.
Challenges unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. 7-4. Play.
Terrific rally. Crowd loved every minute of that. I think they would love to see Choi and Shin win this game just so that the match could be extended. It's a great finale on finals day, the mixed doubles. Always think it's a shame when it's not the last match. Fantastic defence in that rally by, in particular, EOM. Stayed alive and eventually won the point. When you're a game down, you'll take anything that comes your way. Nothing at all that Leon could do about it. it's literally nip and tuck here. Got to say that Ko has been tremendous in the first game and a half of this match. So one of these pairs going to have just a 1 point lead. And they're going for the big game break after this point. Fantastic rally. It's going to say that Choi must have a tired arm, but at least his pair won the point in the end. Mid-game break, brilliant. Well, he's dispatched just about everything so far in this final. Well, that was a fabulous get by Choi. It really was. Did himself a mischief as he played it, but it won the point. Fraction long. 13. Well, it's great defence in particular for EOM, but in the end, just cramped the room a little bit. Ko couldn't do anything with it. Well, I think this is worth the challenge. A slightly delayed reaction. Decided to invoke the services of Hawkeye. Good call.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Stop 14, 13.
Well, Coe's frustrated because he thought that Choi should have been ready. Anyhow, we can't continue.
Wow!
Yeah, Choi won Ko-nil in that little... even his partner was laughing about it. Time a little gap opens up in favour of Choi and Shin. That's a bit of a gift, though. Stop attack from Shin and Choi. Got its rewards in the end. Every time they become the aggressors, you sense that Choi and Shin are going to win the point. It's happened frequently in this second game, and they're on the verge now of taking it to a decider. Shouldn't have a problem from 19-15. Especially not now. Five game points to level the match. That'll work. 21-15 then in the second game. And we're going to a decider.
Final game.
So here we go, the final game of these championships to decide the mixed doubles title. I could smile about it. It's a chance for Choi, he couldn't take it. Didn't have to go for the sideline there, really. Read the intention, completely unguarded. Anywhere in the tram lines would have been fine. Instead of which, it's three love. Called in, and Ko and Ioma challenging. I think anything vaguely close now is probably challengeable. Yeah, back of the baseline.
Challenge unsuccessful. One challenge remaining. Two, three, play.
I haven't seen one of those for a while. Great shot. Flick of the wrist and into the open court it went. Lovely touch at the net by SHIN. Very impressive. To think so quickly. Unerringly down the line. So from 6-2 to 6-5. Again. Has got every sign of being tight and tense, nip and tuck till we have a winner.
Oh!
as well. I think that previous shot from Shin was going way out. Didn't matter. Interesting to note how the pace of the game has slowed right down. Not the rallies, but suddenly longer between points. There's a little bit of friction out there, actually. Gave KOR a little look there, CHOI. Still just a point in this. Anticipated well. Always a slight element of gamble in it, but the rewards when it pays off like that pretty much guarantees you win the point. She's okay, just disappointed, not hurt. Full length dive from CHOI, and she did absolutely everything she could, not once but twice. Through this deciding game, 11-9, KOR and EOM Lee.
Play.
Fantastic rally. Well, usually there's at least one of them on the ground after every 30 or 40 shot rally. This time is CHOI. Some unbelievable gets in this point. They really are.
Thank you.
What a get that was. Not that it did him any good, because EOM just dismissed it. No standing on ceremony there, CHOI. To be honest, it was a pretty routine put away. He's virtually on the service line there. Expecting that at all. Fabulous angle. Well, that's a bit of a gift. Been coming.
14,
13. I said that the pace of this match has really slowed. Play. The longer he stands there, he's just asking for a card. Suddenly, it's a 2-point gap. And there's definitely a bit of needle down there. Because Ko knew that the umpire was going to call a let there, but he made his point nonetheless. And Choi's just made his unceremoniously. It's the psychology behind the actual technique. It's almost as much of the battle. Now, Shin has done the same thing. Swish of the racket from Ko. Disappointed to have netted that. Well, that's a terrific piece of deception. Absolutely no chance of EOM getting to that. So we're all tied up again at 16 points apiece. Who's your money on from here? Bit of seething anger inside Choi Soo-gyu, I think. Thinks the world's against him, and that would have got a bit of that pent-up frustration out of his system. That will not improve his mood. Nudging towards the finish line here. This is a massive point. Well, you felt Choi and Shin had to win that, and they did.
18, 19.
Still go either way as we approach an hour on court in this final game of the 2018 Korea Masters. Still, it's not obvious which of these pairs is going to take the title. 18-19, Shin serving. Nice. want to get to that. Absolutely nothing Choi could do. And two championship points for Ko and Eom, who last won a mixed doubles title 7 years ago. Have not played with each other much since then. Double championship point. That will do. 21-18 in the deciding set. And the 31-year-old and his 27-year-old partner have really given us some entertainment in this final match of the Korea Masters. It took three games to get past Choi and Shin. I think he was getting increasingly weary, actually, Ko, because he started like a train. And then it was all a little bit nervy towards the end, but they got the job done. An hour and a minute on court. 21-12. 15-21. 21-18. That was the moment they sealed the deal. So often the mixed doubles provides superb entertainment, and this was absolutely no exception. Thumbs up from Ko. Just wait for the presentation party to make their way towards the podium. A big hand for Choi and Shin. Both of whom, of course, have been involved in the men's and women's doubles finals, respectively, today. And busy. $500. but Ko and Eon with a superb display, particularly good in that first game, and when the pressure was on right at the end of the match. They will get a check for just shy of $20,000. Tremendously entertaining badminton. It's actually the longest of all five finals. And it seemed to whiz by. It's always the sign of a top match. So let's just recap then the results of the five finals. CHOI and Seo coming past Po and Wang, 2-1. Pretty comfortable for Chang and Jung, also Son and Lee. And then in the women's singles, Li Qingru coming out on top of her. Out of sorts, Han Yuet, 2-love. And then that tremendous mixed doubles match that we've just seen, just over an hour. 2-1, Ko and Eom taking the title. That's about all we have for you, but don't forget, we'll be in Guangzhou for the World Tour Finals. It all starts in just 9 days' time. Until then, from all of us here in South Korea, hope you enjoyed it. It's good night.